As Uganda joined the rest of the world to celebrate International Women's Day on Friday, women leaders in Hoima City gathered to discuss menstrual health and good hygiene within the Bunyoro region. The discussion, dubbed Coffee Talk, was organized by Twekwenyere Foundation Uganda. The women noted that whereas Uganda has celebrated the International Women's Day, the continued stigma associated with menstruation in many societies has wide-ranging effects that limit their participation in public life.
Go to an extent, women and girls, to tear their clothes. But is this sustainable? When we look at sustainability, is it really sustainable? It is not. How many are you going to be tearing per month? And how many do you have?
Patricia Kajuma, the executive director, Twekwenyere Foundation Uganda, pointed out that many girls in communities go through a lot because they lack the right information, materials to use, and lack of access to clean running water. There is also a lack of access and affordable sanitary pads, particularly in rural communities.
With challenges regarding silence, taboos, and cultural myths that are framed around menstruation. So it becomes difficult for them to access accurate information, knowledge, the right materials to use, but also they are not in friendly spaces. You find that there is a lot of stigma and silence surrounding menstruation.
Ronald Mwesigwa, a parent and a resident of Resembe 2, explained that the menstrual stigma is being caused by a lot of secrecy and lack of boy-child empowerment.
When it comes to empowerment, we need to see how best can we include the boy child so that we can reduce on the stigmatization, we can reduce on who is laughing against who.
Let's try to talk to parents so that they can also spare time and talk to their children.
Ida Chebet, a seasoned midwife and sexual reproductive health specialist at Reproductive Health Uganda, explained that poor menstrual hygiene causes many complications and infections, thus asking parents to open up to their girls as early as 10 years.
Most parents are not open to their children, by the way. They become open when they come and see the medical personnel. They really tell you so many complications that they are facing. So we as parents, as senior women teachers, we should take them through the menstrual hygiene, and I think we shall overcome these complications.
Have we left such talks that we used to have, such responsibilities, to go to the commercial people who are just out there to people please and make money and rip everyone off because I am the same girl?
Menstrual stigma refers to the negative social and cultural perceptions, beliefs, taboos and practices surrounding menstruation. It encompasses the perception of menstruation as impure or shameful and often leads to secrecy and emotional distress. Report compiled by Ambrose Niwagabaka Toto for the news.